guys, I'm back with the Hanged Man. Woo! Well, it's actually not very scary up until now. So I'm just going to continue playing it. As you can see, I'm wearing the same t-shirt as in the last video because I'm recording right after the first one. Surprise, surprise! But I really want to get going a bit further right now, so let's just jump back into it. And I am here in the dining room where Keith just left me. Keith is a detective and he was the protagonist in The Boogeyman, the last game. And I think he was a bit of a troubled person and still is. Maybe that's because he left like a 15-year-old kid in a haunted house. He said it's haunted, which he doesn't believe in, but he still told me to like get lost. So he scared the shit out of me and Pop, which is my pet rat. And now I have to find Pop because otherwise Will, the protagonist here, won't leave the building. And very conveniently, he left the door open for me so we can go further up the stairs. I remember this freaking hallway. I remember it so well. Like... Right, okay. There's nothing in here. Because the clue here is... And now I'm not gonna spoiler it, but I'm not going to look into every room because it's just boring. But there is going to be a room where something's on. No. I think I have to find a knife or something. I think I have to look into every room. Okay, this is going to be so boring. Try 1 million hours later. Come on, something. It's just, you know, I think this is the point where I have to use the freaking spray can. No? The thing is, the place really is haunted and we're just going in circles, but I don't know when he's going to realize that. And I think I have to go through every room again. And again, and again, until he's like, wait a minute. I've been here before. You don't say, because it's every room just looks the freaking same. Now he's realizing it. I feel like I keep ending up in the same place. Yes, you do. So use this. Maybe this used to be a floor number. Come to think of it, what floor am I on? Yeah, I don't know. Damn it, where'd the jerk go? Yeah, Keith's jerk. Let's use the spray can. Yeah, it's fine. Zero. Okay, I've been here already. Okay. Right? I'm just going upstairs now. Because I don't want to look through each and every room again. Because it's just dirty beds. Right, there should be something in... I knew it! It won't open. It's been painted over with concrete, but there's a small gap under the door. Okay. Maybe if I go over here. I want to go in here. Something. Okay. Has that sound been here before? I kind of hear something. Someone's crying. Oh, I hate that I have to go through each and every room again. Like, Oh! I think it's coming from here. There's something written on the desk. The monster's driving me out of here. I don't want to leave. It's probably blood. Okay, everything else is empty. It stops when I'm in here. Alright, okay. Yeah, it's just... I think you should leave. Ah, okay. I'm upstairs now. There's a notice about interviews on the bulletin board. Patient said to leave the hospital. Oh, it's a hospital, it's not a prison. Must be interviewed by the doctor within 1 week. Okay, good. There's another building map. Alright. Ah, okay. So, I have been the one that has been 1511. 1411. That's where I have been and looked at. Okay, good. Check the map. Just looking at the map. Mario map. So I am now at the, I think, exam room. I think. Can't go in here. Can I go in here? Maybe I have another key. Nope. I hate it. What is that key for? Like, it's really bugging me. I want to know what the key is for. Just use it. Nope. Okay. Let's go downstairs and try to get into this room again. No? Was it one? Oh, it was on the other floor, I think. Okay, let's go upstairs. And let's go. Come on. I want to go inside. I don't remember what I have to do. Ah, this is so annoying. Okay. So this is the room where the crying is coming from. So what room is it? It's one above. 111. I think it's 1508. It's 1508. So didn't we get this one book from 1508? This storybook. No, and I don't want to read it again. It's, yeah, collected from 1508, returned to library. Andy Thorne, yeah, maybe Andy Thorne, that's where Andy Thorne is from. Maybe I should try and use the book here? Yeah, me too. This is so annoying, this is so annoying. Whoa! Shit, what was that? There was blood coming out of the room! God damn it! I didn't know that. Oh, okay. I totally forgot that one. Maybe. I think I have to go in that room, but do I want to? Oh, that wasn't here before. There's a dark red stain on it. It's probably just like paint. Ooh, there's something under the bed. My beloved... Is that Alec? Is it saying, yeah, it's saying, Alec. I heard you're being moved to the back building in 2 weeks. I suppose I'll never get to meet you again. If you can still understand me at all, read this letter carefully. 1 week from now, I'll come to see you. Sit at the rightmost seat in the visiting room. I'll have a knife put under the table. Take it with you in secret. There will be two there, but only take one. Arkin will bring the other one to you if you fail. Arkin has told me he'll definitely get his letter to you. This letter to you. Once you've read this, hide it and don't show anyone. Because if anyone finds it, it will mean trouble for Arkin. Your loving mother. Okay, so it's probably a mental hospital. And there was a mother who was trying to get her son out of it. I guess. Right. Okay, so I have to get the knife. I think I have to get the knife. Okay, I have to go to the visiting room. Where's the visiting room again? Next to the dining room. Okay, let's just see whether I remember how to get there. That's the visiting room. No, that's the dining room. Okay, so how convenient. Keith left everything open for me, didn't he? Only now you think it gives you a bad feeling. You're an idiot, Will. You really are. It's already a really creepy place. Okay. Can't I go in there? Maybe the key? It worked! Woo! Okay. I think either it's here. Or here, the rightmost. No, it's not. Ah! Okay. Yeah, because it's the rightmost, because the patient is going to sit there. So it's the left side for us and the right side for visitors, I presume. I have a knife now. Gonna stab the bitch. Right. I still think I have... Okay, it's probably just that hobo. Okay. Shit just got real. God damn it. Right, I'm just going back now. Yeah, I'm going back because I think I still have to get in this room. With that has been painted over with concrete. Yeah, it's just my rabbit. My rabbit being
Pop!
Pop! Come back! You little shit! Come back! Come back! God damn it, come back! Can't use the knife. That's why I was always like shoving against the shelves. Right, okay, let's go. There's a hole near the bottom of the wall. Yeah, go in there. Go through the hole. Wall. Hole. Hole. Hole in wall. Oh, hey, it's the hobo.
Hey.
Hi.
You were the one in the hall earlier, huh? I thought about talking to you, but you were praying.
Okay.
Pop!
Oh, this? Is it your pet?
Yeah. Give it back.
He's more like my friend, kind of.
That's a cute friend you have. But still kind of weird to have a rat friend. They can't talk, right?
Yeah, but pets can be friends. Right? Yeah, I'm looking at my rabbit, but she's ignoring me right now. I think she's angry that I turned off the lights. Yeah, I'm sorry, sweetie. I love you. Mwah! Yeah, I'm not going to pick her up because she hates picking up. And I respect that, okay? I respect my friends. Alright? Yeah, let's move on.
Pop can talk.
Yeah, he can talk.
Oh, really? I've never met a talking rat before. Hey, Pop. Wanna say hi to Ed?
Ed? Okay.
Your name's Ed?
Yeah, short for Edward.
You don't say.
Well, do you live here, Ed?
Nah. I have a home, but I can't go back. I'm staying here for a while. I would be leaving soon, but I've got something to do. So I'm still not sure.
Mm-hmm. Pop!
What? Pop!
He ran off. I guess he hates me.
No, he doesn't hate you, Ed.
Pop.
Yeah, Pop, you fucking idiot. Running
Were
away on the break.
Looking for him? Sorry I made him run. I'd like to help look, but I'm busy searching too.
What are you searching for?
A notebook. It's small and black. I thought it was in this room, but I can't find it.
It's probably the one we have.
Well, I'll look for Pop, but I'll bring that if I find it. Could you catch Pop if he comes back here?
Oh, sure thing. Thanks, Will.
Yeah, we have a friend now. Great, and I think I have the item you're looking for. It's a dusty notebook that says Andy Thorne. Yeah, I didn't want to read it again. Anything else in here? Hi.
Was the notebook really here?
Yeah, it should have been. Maybe it was in some other room. I'll have to look around later.
You're making a real mess there.
I got hungry, so I've been eating. I think your friend wanted my leftovers.
Yeah, he's just thinking about food. And there's a giant hole in the ground. Okay. We'll just leave, because this place is cute. Oh, should I turn on my light again? Yeah. And, yeah, where should I go now? Have a knife now? So I can't go in here. So I can't go in here. Come on here. Maybe Keith left. The game wants me to go in there, so I'm going to go in there, but, like, if this was real life, I wouldn't go in there. I would run. I would fucking run. There it is again. Why is there someone crying again? Ah. The hell. It's not a mirror. I can tell you that it's not a mirror. It's a see-through thing. Yeah, it's a see-through thing. It's a magic mirror. Ooh. Being watched from a mirror is pretty scary. Is that what the monster in the mirror is? Maybe. But I think it's more metaphorical than that. All documents. Oh, there's some cans. Like, do you have a Pepsi for me? Trash. It's empty. There was something in the other room, so I'm going to have a look. Yeah. We'll open. What just happened? Did he just like pfft? He just fainted. This is why I hate the dark. It, because there's always something here, there. Uh-huh.
Okay, well, good night.
Mom?
Mom? Oh, that little voice is so cute.
Yes?
It's nothing.
If you say so. Good night.
That's a will. Someone. When it's night and the room goes dark, he always appears. He never says a word, he's just there. Okay. He must be a mime. Yeah, because of that top. Try to call for mum, but it's pointless. He disappears once the lights come on. Yeah, but I want him gone, so turn on the lights. Just who is he? Does he want to tell me something? Is he my friend or is he my foe?
You've got guts to take a nap here, kid.
You! What did you come here for?
Oh, he took off his jacket, didn't he?
Did you find your rat?
He's not that bad after all.
I'm sure he'll have a fine life out in the wild. Now, how about you give up and head home, Mr. William Morton?
How do you know my name?
Huh? Why do you...
Yeah, he's a detective because...
Word of advice. When you run from home, don't bring your student ID. Even if you do hide it in your jacket.
Oh, did you pickpocket it?
You can't just take people's things.
Yeah. Right?
What is it you skipped school and came all this way for?
Yeah, I would like to know that
too. How about this then? What kind of business do you have with David?
Yeah, he knows David from the boogeyman.
I'm asking you what you want with David, resident at 135 Womack Street. What's your relation to him?
I'm his cousin! No, stop snooping already!
One more thing. Are you receiving any threats?
Threats?
Huh?
Demon child, huh? That's one worrying letter to be walking around with.
Ah, he just looked into my pocket, didn't he?
Give that back!
Yeah, I want that note back!
Answer my question. Or would you rather be lectured by a scary officer at the police station?
No. But I want my threat letter back. Please?
I'm not being threatened. I think.
Okay.
Huh?
That sounded like you know what you're talking about.
I said give it back. Why do you know David? Does he know you?
Met him a while back. Now we go drinking sometimes.
Oh.
So what's your story?
It's none of your business.
Really? Well, go off and look for your rat.
None of your business! Ugh! X-teen mode on.
You come with me.
Huh? And why should I?
Cause I'm...
Speak up, kid.
Cause I'm scared! Walking around here on my own! You just laughed, didn't you?
Yeah.
I'm not laughing.
You just laughed.
Liar.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm the liar. Why would you be getting scared now? You were waltzing around here just fine earlier.
Because Pop was with me. That's why I could still handle it.
Aww. Aww.
If Pop's there, I'm fine. If I listen to Pop, we'll always be okay.
Aww.
I should have known. I shouldn't have come here. Way out to this town. In all this snow.
Aww, Will.
Pop tried to stop me. He said I shouldn't, but I kept insisting.
You hit your head, kid. If you really think your rat's talking to you, you ought to visit a hospital.
Excuse me?
If Pop doesn't come back, what do I do? It's so cold, and I'm all alone. What if...
Hey now, don't cry. You're 14, right? Can't go crying that easily.
Excuse me? Men can also cry if they want to. Keith, stop spreading that really toxic masculinity.
I'm not crying.
You do cry if you want to.
Listen, this building's full of rats. Seen a bunch along the way. Does yours have any identifying features?
His right leg's bent. There's a little fur missing on it.
All right. If I catch him, I'll bring him to you, but don't get your hopes up. You can keep searching some, but be ready to give up if you don't find him. You're not staying here past nightfall. Got that?
Okay.
You won't come with me?
Do I look like I came here for a relaxing stroll?
Just, who are you?
I'm a detective.
And why are you here?
That, my friend, is none of your business.
Yeah, but you want to know everything about me.
Well, what's your name?
Keith. Now get on your
way. Uh-huh, I did remember his name correctly, didn't I? Now, fuck off, kid. A clutch bag. All the years you suffered, those were the best years of your life. Georg Schmidt? Oh no, it's George Schmidt. That's a German name.
Hey, stop digging around in there.
Don't threaten me!
Yeah, but you went through his pockets.
Is that photo yours? That's this building, right?
Not mine. I'm borrowing it. Although, I doubt I'll give it back.
So, you stole it, in other words. Can I go in here now? Yes.
Hey, Keith. Did you unlock this door?
Who knows? Must have been unlocked already.
Okay, that's reassuring. Right, it's dark again. Let's turn on the lights. Turn on the lights. Another key. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Can I believe he's really a detective? What would a detective be doing here? Maybe I should ask about it. Yeah, ask about it. Let's try and ask him. I think he's not going to tell anything.
What kind of building is this anyway? A hospital?
It was an old mental hospital. It got shut down ages ago, though. After millionaire Jim Cork bought up the forest, it was repurposed as a homeless shelter for a few years.
That is a really strange name.
Shelter?
A place the homeless could call home.
Was that incident 15 years ago thing true?
Sorry, I'm not really one to tell spooky stories to people liable to wet their pants.
Yeah, thanks.
This building's strange. There are these shadows or something. And locked doors opening up all of a sudden.
Locked doors? Well, that'd be me.
Huh?
Unlike you, little trespasser, I have permission to be here. So I also borrowed some of the keys. Of course it's old, so lots have been lost to time.
But still, there are these shadow things. They're moving all around.
Oh yeah, shadows everywhere. Because it's dark. And you're freaked out, so you think they're moving.
No, there was definitely something moving. And trying to catch me.
What? Go on. Find your rat.
Okay. Going. Why does it do you turn your lights off every time I talk to someone? Okay, I've been in here. Maybe I can go in here now. Oh wait, it's locked from the inside, isn't it? Yeah, okay, I can't go in here. Maybe. Something here. I couldn't go in here. Maybe here? Yay! That backtracking is. Oh!
Pop?
Pop! Pop!
Pop! Good.
I found you.
Come on down, Pop. Let's go. This place is just.
Tell her, come down here! He's not a dog, is he?
You can't get down? Wait there. I'll get you down.
Why can't we hear him talk now? There's something on the ground. It is a tarot card. And it is the chariot. Oh! Okay, it's a whole stack. Good. Oh, I think tarot cards are really creepy. Look, it's a hangman. Yay. You can't reach. And there's something on the shelf. What is this painting? It looks like a rat has been disfigured. You know what? I think whatever I'm doing, Pop is going to go in there because he's not going to go back with us. Can I go? Maybe if I go outside and inside again? Yeah, that's the magic of a game, isn't it? Sound.
Pop!
Yeah. Told you so.
Why did you run away, Pop?
tabloid. The tragedy that befell the homeless, the happy murders? Are you familiar with a certain incident that occurred in the Deep Woods on the outskirts of Marvel Hill? Deep Woods Hospital, which once accommodated patients with mental illness, was abandoned in 1970 and long neglected. But it was later purchased, woods and all, by one Jim Cork, famous millionaire and philanthropist. Cork made use of the old hospital as a shelter for the homeless, calling in priests to open a chapel and running a social action program. Oh, that's the chapel we encountered in the beginning. Yet all this came to an end with the gruesome incident which would come to be called the Happy Murders. One winter day, a priest in the chapel noticed something amiss with the shelter's residents. He attempted to question them as they kept suspiciously silent and soon discovered 5 corpses in the building. The causes of death all differed, from stabbing to strangling, and they were all found in all different locations. Yet there was a common feature. The bodies were all in plain sight, hanging from a rope in the room. After police questioning, 5 among the residents confessed to murder. So 5 murders, murderers and 5 murders, okay? As to their motives, they gave various reasons, having an argument or having never liked the victim, but they spoke not a word about the bodies hanging from ropes. The police announced that the most recent corpse was 3 days dead and the oldest corpse had been dead for 3 weeks. 3 weeks! Now you're noticing something bizarre, aren't you? In the 3 weeks since the first murder, 4 other murders took place, and the homeless residing in the shelter decided not to report them but to go on pretending they didn't see a thing. After the 5 criminals confessed and stated their motives, they all made this final comment: "Now I finally become happy." Cork had the facility completely shut down, and the homeless living there all dispersed without ever speaking of what had happened. Deep Woods Hospital has not been demolished nor renewed since the Happy Murders. It simply sits there quietly in the forest. Yeah. What's this? Is this the incident from 15 years ago Keith mentioned? Yeah. And how convenient that this tabloid was right there Pop was sitting. Yeah, would you take it? That shadow hasn't been there a minute ago. Let's just leave. With the flow right now. Oh god, where am I? So, we just learned about the Happy Murders, and I think this is again a really good time to stop the game for now. I hope you enjoyed the game. Just tell me down in the comments below what you thought, and maybe you have some recommendations for other horror games. I really would appreciate that. And I hope I see you next time, guys. Bye!